breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
Some big changes in our weather this Christmas week. The soggy morning rain has moved out. Get ready for the big chill. Let's get started with Chief Meteorologist John Sessler.
Here he is, John. That cold blast starts arriving tonight, right?
Yeah, in fact, the cold air is already moving in, Michael and Carol, into the mountainous areas with that northwesterly wind, which is quite strong. So expect in the mountains overnight lows tonight in the 20s and overnight lows in the low to mid 30s outside of the mountains in the upstate. Our storm system that brought us all our rain and our spring-like temperatures. Yesterday we were 70 for tying the all-time record on this date at the GSP National Airport. Last time it was 70 degrees was back in 1970. And you can see all this rain continues to move away from us. So if you're doing some Christmas shopping in the upstate this evening, you're heading on out, expect a mostly cloudy to partly cloudy skies, a little bit of a breeze out of the north, so bundle up because the temperature will drop to 48 degrees at 8 o'clock this evening, 42 degrees at 10 o'clock. For the mountains, very strong winds out of the north and northwest, so wind chills will be very low, so bundle up in layers. It's already 40 with mostly cloudy skies, partly cloudy skies expected at 8 o'clock at 39 degree temperature, 34 degrees at 10 o'clock this evening. As I mentioned, overnight lows will be in the 20s. Some flurries and some snow showers out to our west may affect a part of the mountains late tonight and tomorrow. I'll show you where a little bit later on. Now back to you, Carol.
Thank you, John. A lot of last-minute shoppers out there, but remember, whatever you buy today, someone may be taking it back 3 days from now. After Christmas returns are a reality for many, and some stores get higher marks than others when it comes to being return friendly. WYFF News 4's Tim Waller is live and local along Woodruff Road tonight with a list of the best and the worst. Tim?
Carol, this year some retail stores have already shortened the length of time you have to take things back. Of course, others give you plenty of time. The key is knowing which stores do what. In the hustle and bustle of Christmas shopping, there will always be a few missteps.
Regift mode happens when you can't return something. It goes in the regift bin.
It happens because some after Christmas returns can be difficult or impossible if you wait too long.
I think at least 3 or 4 months. If I know that'd be at least how long it would take me to get around to it.
Right. It depends on the store, and this year some stores fared better than others when it comes to easy and friendly returns. One survey found that Costco has one of the best policies out there, number one in fact. There's no time limit on returns, except for electronics, which have a generous 90-day window. You take something back, they give you cash or a check, instead of store credit like some places give. REI, Kohl's, Walmart, Target, Macy's, and Home Depot also scored high. But these two stores got the worst ranking when it comes to returns because of their many restrictions. Sears, for example, has a 30, 60, and 90-day policy on returns, depending on the item, which GoBankingRates.com calls confusing. And Best Buy, it says, gives customers only 15 days to take something back, unless you spend $1,500 a year at the store, in which case they give you 30 days. What's the least amount of time a store should give? That depends on who you ask.
I would say that, you know, if they give you 30 days, that should be plenty.
You're good with that?
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, here's what we do know. Keeping up with all these return policies is nearly impossible because they keep changing. In fact, the National Retail Federation says 28% of retailers this year changed their return policies heading into the holidays, and it's something they do each and every year, so you got to be on the lookout. Tim Waller, WYFF News 4, live and on Woodruff Road.
Yeah, good luck getting back here, Tim. We appreciate it. Live look here, dare we take it, from our Sky Cam at Woodruff Road. That is the Shops at Green Ridge shopping area down there below. To say it's heavy traffic is kind of like saying take a sweater to the North Pole. WYFF News 4's Myra Ruiz knows about crowds. She's live and local somehow from Haywood Mall. Myra, good evening.
Well, we are at one of the most popular spots of Haywood Mall right now. This is Santa's Village, and he's the man of the hour. As you can see, there are a long line of people waiting in line to see Santa. This has been busy throughout the holiday season. We have a few of his elves also standing by. Now, we're told he's going to make his big entrance coming down this way. Meantime, there are people also shopping, taking advantage of some of the last-minute deals. You can find them by looking at the storefront windows. They're advertising anything from 20 to even 50% off, and it's not even the day after Christmas yet. So quite a few last minute 11th hour shoppers. They say it's sometimes easier to get these things done at while they wait till the last minute because, you know, it's a little bit easier to find things on the shelves. And we have noticed that the traffic has picked up quite a bit since we were first here several hours ago out in the parking lots. Kind of crowded, but we've noticed that people are making it easy on themselves by dropping off to their friends or family at the door and then going to look for a parking space. Also seeing people resting on a lot of the benches and chairs throughout the mall, but mostly people just excited that Christmas is almost here. We're seeing whole families out here at the mall, and again, back here outside Santa's Village, people are lining up to see the big guy in red. 2 days before Christmas, knowing that he will have a lot of wishes to fill in just 2 days. Myra Ruiz, WYFF News 4, live in Greenville.
Oh, the big guy is probably in traffic himself. Myra, thank you. The Greenville County Sheriff's Office is looking for some help tonight, trying to crack a couple of cases of convenience store robbery. The first case happened at around 10:15 last Thursday night at the Little Cricket on Augusta Road. Deputies say this man tried to buy a drink, then jumped the counter and demanded money. An employee opened the cash register. The man grabbed some cash and ran. The other robbery happened on Augusta Road. Deputies say this man walked into the hot spot at 3:50 Friday morning, walked up to the register, took the cash drawer, and simply ran off with it. Deputies believe these cases may be related. If you know anything about them, call Crime Stoppers. You don't have to give your name. They're at 23 Crime. And the Malden police need your help investigating a deadly wreck in the town. A reconstruction team was out this afternoon trying to figure out what happened. This is West Butler Road in Malden between Watley Circle and West Point Boulevard. A detective tells us the impact happened around 9 this morning. It involved a minivan, a station wagon, and a box truck. One person was killed. Two others ended up at the hospital, and the Malden police here again are looking for help, trying to figure out exactly what happened here. If you're a witness, call that number on your screen, 864-289-8900.
The year isn't quite over, of course, but we already know which types of businesses in the upstate received the most complaints this year. The Better Business Bureau says in 2013, debt collectors were number one for complaints. Number two on the list, used car dealers, followed by new car dealers. Loan companies came in fourth, followed by auto repair shops. These businesses round out the top 10. Roofing contractors, restaurants, heating and air conditioning businesses, check cashing services, and property management companies. A special visitor stopped by the GHS Children's Hospital this morning. Jeremy Clements and his racing team stopped by each room. They handed out special gifts for the patients like teddy bears, stickers, candy canes, NASCAR toys. Clements said he just wanted to do whatever he could to make the children smile.
Especially during Christmas, it's got to be hard on kids being in a hospital. So if we can just brighten their day any, that's what we're here for.
Clemens, as you probably know, is from Spartanburg. He wrapped up his NASCAR season 16th in points.
And there is still time. You can still donate to the Holiday Sunshine Fund. We're waving you in. In fact, so far today, many of you have donated more than $4,300. We thank you for that. And that brings the grand total for the season to more than $68,000. Again, there is time to donate. Send your gift to P.O. Box 1688, Greenville, South Carolina, 29602. Or you can simply do so online at WYFF4.com. Look for the Holiday Sunshine Fund link on the homepage, and need we remind you one more time, 100% of your financial gift goes to organizations that help our neighbors here at home who are in need.